I have a question for you. Suppose this right here are pizzas. How would you cut your pizza? Well, perhaps the first one is just that you can just do it the usual way. Namely, we'll just cut this right in the middle and then cut it horizontally. And then we'll just keep cutting like this. And we have the classic 8 slices, right? Great, no problem on that. But how else would you cut your pizza? Have you guys ever cut your pizza vertically? Well, you see, can we just do this, 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 and that? And maybe horizontally as well, right? But anyway, I don't know if you have ever done this. If you have, leave a comment down below and let us know, right? One more. How else can you cut your pizza though, if you have any other ideas? Maybe you just cut a little corner and just eat it, but that's kind of like the same as vertical, huh? Let's see. Okay, so if you want to have a new way to cut your pizza, then keep on watching, because this right here is kind of cool. Here's another way that you can try and do it. Pick a point on the circle, right, on the pizza, and what you do is, you are going to kind of shoot out the rays, so you just cut right here, so that's the first cut, and then you are going to make another cut like this, and you can make another cut like that, and you are going to make another cut like that. How's that? And we have 5 slices, pretty cool, huh? But anyway, of course, you can cut the pizza whatever way that you want, but anyway though, this is the classic way. But this right here is how you find the area under the curve with vertical rectangles, right? So, remember, if I put down the x and y axis right here, you can see we can actually use the usual integration, the usual formula for the area under the curve to find out how big this area is. No problem on that. This right here is what I'm going to talk about right now, namely how to find the area of a polar curve. Namely, suppose I just want to find out this slice right here for the area. How big is that? How can we do so? Well, have a look. So, how to find the area of a polar curve from one angle to the other? Because you see, we start with a point, and then we just make a first cut, and then we rotate so much, and then we make another cut. That's the idea of the polar region. So here we go. Suppose we have a polar curve. I'll just say given r is equal to a function in terms of theta. So this is a polar function. Well, I will give you guys a polar curve. Let's say the polar curve looks like this. I'm sorry about the picture, but you know, Anyway though, this is how the polar curve is defined for the area. You start with the origin, and then you are going to make a ray, right? So you're just going to make a cut from wherever to wherever. So let's say we can go from here to here, and then we are just going to make another cut, let's say like this right here. This right here, let's say is theta 1, meaning the first angle. And then this right here, I will just say that's to be theta 2. It's very similar to our original idea of the area under the curve from A to B. Same thing. But we do not find the area under the curve anymore because in the polar situation, it's about rotation, right? Now, how can we find the area of this curve though? Well, first thing first, you break things down into small pieces and then you analyze that. Let's see if we have the formula for that, right? And then once you find the formula for that, you add up everybody. That's the idea of integration. So this shape is so weird, but if I narrow it down, if I make it small enough, so let me just put this down in blue. Let's say we are just go from here to here. Let's say it's meant to be small enough, right? In that case, what kind of shape do we see? So just imagine it like this, and if this change is small enough, the truth is, this part is going to be a nice arc. What's a nice arc? Namely, just like a circle. Like, circular arc. There we go. And the deal is that, in fact, we do know the area of a sector. That's why I brought this up. So it's not because I just want to ask you guys. Oh, I did want to ask you guys for fun. But we do know how to find the area of a sector, right? So have a look. Take a look right here. The area of the sector, perhaps I'll just write this down right here for you guys. So I'll just say area of a sector, meaning just like this piece right here, a slice of a pizza. And you can see this and that are very similar. But the formula is, you have to know 1 half pi and, no, sorry, 1 half r squared theta. There's no pi. Why? Because theta is in terms of radians. So you will end up with the pi already, right? So remember, the theta right here has to be in radians. Radians, right? That's the DO, the area of the sector. Now, here is the DO. This right here, it's meant to be just a small change in the angle theta. So what should I do right here, from here to here, in terms of its angle? Well, this right here will be d theta, isn't it? The small change in the theta. And then the r changes, and we'll just use that. There you have it. The area of this right here, I will just write this down. We actually have d theta, the small change in the angle, and then we have r squared, and then we have 1 half, which represents that right here. But if you want to find out the area of all this, the area will be equal to, of course, this is just one piece. We will have to integrate, and we care about theta 1 to theta 2. So I'll just write this down for you. Theta 1 to theta 2. That's pretty much it. And of course, r is not allowed in the theta world, but we do know that r is a function of theta. So I can just write this down. Theta 2. This right here is equal to theta 1 to theta 2, and then we have the 1 half, and then the r is just whatever the function that we are talking about, and then square that, and then we have the d theta, just like this, alright? So, it's very similar to the idea of the rectangle, right, for the usual situation. You just kind of make it small, so that's why the base right here is dx instead of just like the width or the length, and then you have the y. Same idea. Okay, let me tell you guys though, the hardest part of this is not remembering the formula, is to find the angle. That's actually the hardest part. But in this video, I'll just show you guys how to do the easy situation first, right? And then in the next video, I'll show you guys how to find out the angles and all that. So I would say find the area enclosed by the polar curve, namely, I would just say r is equal to cosine theta, because we have done this a few times. And I would say from pi over 4 to pi over 6. Sorry, let me actually try to fit everything right here. Find the area enclosed by cosine theta, and this is the polar curve, and I'll just write this down. And theta in between of, let's say pi over 6, pi over 6 is smaller than pi over 4, but actually let's say pi over 6 to pi over 3, like this, all right? So now, here we go. If you graph cosine theta, you get a circle that looks like this, right? Pi over 6, which is 30 degrees, I'm just going to say it's about right here, right? Pi over 3 is 60 degrees, so it's going to be about like that. So theta 1, theta 2, which is given right away, so this right here is not so bad. And then I just have to find the area right here, right? Great. Now we can just apply that formula. Area is equal to the integral going from pi over 6 to pi over 3. And then we'll just do the usual thing. 1 half, and then the function right here is cosine theta. So I'll just put down cosine theta. And then we will have to square that. And then the d theta right here. And now we can just work this out. All right. So if we work this out by hand, well, you guys should remember how to do the integral by hand, because the final exam is coming. So it depends. Sometimes I will just say, hey, do the integral on the calculator, but sometimes you still have to do the integrals by hand just for the final, all that stuff, right? By the way, let me show you guys how to do this by hand. Okay, so we have this being equal to, let me put this down right here, which is 1/2, and then the integral, and then we have pi over 6, and then we have pi over 3, right? Put a 1/2 to the front. And then the inside is just cosine square theta, and then d theta. All right, 1/2 is 1/2, good. But what's cosine theta? Cosine square theta. We will have to utilize the identity for that, right? And that is what? Well, I'll remind you guys, this right here is the same as 1/2 times 1 plus, right? When you have sine, it's minus. If you have cosine, it's actually plus. Cosine of 2 theta. Because right here is just 1 theta, so right here you actually get 2 theta for that. And that's pretty much it. And then you can just continue with the usual business. So this times that is 1 over 4. And then I'm just going to put down the parentheses for the result of the integration. 1 in the theta world, we get theta. Integrating cosine, we get positive sine. Right? So this right here stays positive. The input is 2 theta, so we still have 2 theta, but we are going backwards, so be sure you divide the derivative of 2 theta. Derivative 2 theta is 2, so be sure you divide the 2. So I'll put down 1/2 right here. So that's what we have. And then I will just have to go from pi over 6 to pi over 3, like this. All right, you can see that I don't have enough space. I will have to erase all this. And let's see what we have. So I have 1 over 4 all the way in the front. So let me just put that down all the way in the front. First, let me put down pi over 3 right here. So we have pi over 3 and then plus 1/2 sine of 2 times pi over 3. So that's 2 pi over 3 like this. And this right here is the first part, okay? Then we are going to minus and plug in pi over 6, and then we just pretty much do the rest. So we have 2, and then we have sine of 2, and then we have pi over 6, like this. Yeah, and big parentheses on the outside. All right, I will show you guys all the work, I promise. First, what's sine of 2 pi over 3? Well, just think about the unit circle, or if you would like, just draw this real quick. Convert 2 pi over 3 into degrees. 2 pi is 360 degrees, divided by 3 is 120. So it looks like we will have it like this, right? 120 degrees. And then you can just draw a reference triangle. This right here is 60, and then you will get square root of 3, and this right here is 2. So this right here is square root of 3 over 2, right? Square root of 3 over 2. Well, if you have sine of pi over 3, pi over 3 is 60 degrees, which is right here, right? So this is 60 degrees, which is again square root of 3 and then 2. So this part is square root of 3 over 2. All right, now I'm just going to write down the rest for you guys. I still have the 1 over 4 all the way in the front. Let me just put that all the way in the front. Here we have pi over 3. 1/2 times that is square root of 3 over 4. So I'll just put that down. Plus square root of 3 over 4. Distribute this, we get minus pi over 6. That would be minus, okay? And then this and that is square root of 3 over 4. Like, yeah, good. Now, we can see this is actually pretty nice because this and that cancel out nicely, and then we can just get the common denominator, namely multiply this by 2 and 2, and we have 1 over 4 times this minus that is just pi over 6. Yes, lastly, we get pi over 24. And that right there is the answer for this area right here, right? Pi over 24. All right, so recap, know the formula, but pay close attention to oops, this should be a pi over 6, sorry. And pay close attention to how to find the angles. If the angles are given, this right here is seriously not so bad, and you still have to remember your integrations. If the angles are not given, then you will have to watch my other videos to see how to find out the angles, right? Anyway, that's it for this. And if you have any questions, leave them down below in the comment section. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.